is chivalry dead? And if it is it because ladies are no longer special? Is that what it is? Have they destroyed it for themselves? Lady Danielle Di Masi is Breakfast's etiquette expert and joins us. Danielle, good morning
to
you. So is chivalry dead, do you think?
No, it's not dead, but we might just need a little pump up.
All right, because it is so close to death,
right.
Let's remind people what chivalry is. Have
Perfect.
A look at this. Essentially, three gentlemanly gestures. Here they are, one, two, three. Opening doors so that women can go through, ladies, girls can go through first because
yep.
you're just a man.
Absolutely.
Offering your seat. So let's assume everyone's about the same age and mm-hmm. there aren't enough seats to go around. Some of the men get up to let some of the women sit down.
Yes.
No swearing or offensive language. That one, I think, is just... I think the boat is well and truly left on that.
Yeah, well, we can bring it back.
Let's handle that one first.
Okay,
so what
perfect.
We're saying is it is chivalrous for a man not to use foul language around a woman.
All of these underpinning information under this is that you're showing respect and gratitude for anyone that is in your presence. So it actually doesn't matter if you're a woman or a man. It's just a respect for those people around you. So if you are using offensive language in public, then you're not considering other people, that there might be children in the cafe,
right.
grandparents in the cafe. It's just rude.
Okay, but that's not so much chivalry as it just is good manners, isn't
yeah,
it? It's good manners.
All of this is just good manners.
All right, offering a seat. Now, what
yes.
I would say here is I know a number of people, since I've been thinking about this,
mm-hmm.
who've come to me, men, who have said that they have stood up for women, and the women have said... the women have said, we're quite happy to stand.
Yeah.
You know, so the implication is, what, you think I can't stand because I'm a woman?
Yes.
Now, the reaction by most chivalrous men would be, oh, to hell with you.
And I agree. And so my point here is, if we want the gentlemen to come back, then we need to act like ladies. And it does allow us to do that. And like I said, if people are giving you behaviours out of respect and gratitude, then you need to give back respect and gratitude. It might be 10% of the people that say, you know, I can find my own seat, I can open my own door.
Mm.
And they're the things that people remember. So they're like, well, like you said,
that's exactly
it.
Right. That's
yeah.
Do you know, I remember I used to work with a blind man.
Right.
And he said that so often he found it frustrating when people came up to ask him if they could help him cross the road.
Hmm.
Because he wanted to cross the road on his own.
Right.
But he would always say yes because he said, I know one day there'll be a blind man
yes.
who needs help across the road and no one will offer because the last blind man said, no, I can do it myself.
And that should be the saying that everyone in this country hears. It isn't just about... it has nothing to do with equality. You talk about these topics and people are like, oh, it's, you know, we're equal now. It's respect.
Is it, though? Is it a weeny bit old-fashioned?
No. It's respect. It doesn't matter what gender you are, what age you are, you should give up your seat for someone that's older than you, that's pregnant women. You see pregnant women on the bus standing.
Yeah,
and
yeah.
there's someone in their 20s, female, male. So absolutely everyone in society should be showing these behaviours, and that's what it comes down to. But if you get the behaviours, you should be grateful, even if you're like, I can open my own doors.
Yeah.
It's not sexist.
Because the trouble is so many of those people, and we're talking women, so many of those women, they just carry this baggage
yeah.
around with them. That, you know, I'm equally as good, and they have this like political argument going on in their head all the time, and it does destroy it for other people.
Yeah. Manners has nothing to do with equality, and I have to say that right now. It's
Are
not
we
sexist.
Fighting a losing battle just having this conversation?
No. I think once people lose that sense of entitlement that they have to say that everyone needs to behave a certain way around me, but they don't give it back, that's when the shift will change.
You are so right, Lady Danielle Di Masi. You are just so clever and so lovely.
Thanks.
It's a bit of a shame, though, isn't it? Because it is this double-edged sword that in the workplace, you don't want gender to play a part. You want to be the person that's fit for the job, not based on your gender. But then if you're at work and someone opens the door for you, gender comes
isn't
into
it
play.
Lovely, isn't
yeah,
that
but
lovely?
A lady
I love it.
Should
it's
open
so
a door for you too. Right. Everyone should be holding
be
doors open.
Everyone
so then
be
it's
lovely.
Not really chivalry,
right.
because chivalry
right.
is about a man being nice to a woman. It's just you're just saying it's about people being nice to one another.
Absolutely.
Everyone should be lovely.